Thank you. Praise you and I will honor you every day.
Hallelujah.
All of you for bringing it to my forefront. I praise you before my eyes, and God, I will not do anything according to your word. Anything that is not correct according to your word. Bring it out of me. Bring it out of me. Give me a clear heart. Give me a clear spirit. Give me a clear soul that I can start new, that I can be reborn, refresh, renew, rehabilitate. Thank you,
Lord.
Father, I thank you for all that you are, all that you have done. You are worthy of all praise, every praise that I give, every ounce of strength that I can give you. You are worthy for it. Thank you, Lord. And I recommit myself to you, Lord Jesus. I recommit myself to you, Lord. I honor you with my actions. I honor you in all that I do. Father, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Lead and guide me, Lord Jesus. Lead and guide me, Lord. Lead and guide me, Father. Show me what I need to do, Lord Jesus. Directly, Lord. Father, thank you, Lord. Clear away anything that's unrighteous. Clear away anything that's not of you. Clear away anything that will belong to you. Everything that is not of you, Lord. I want it removed. I want it removed. I want it out of my life, Lord. I just want to commit to you, Lord. Need to commit to you, Lord Jesus. Anything that is incorrect, Lord. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Father, we're here to
thank you, Jesus.
Father, I'm here to give you praise.
Thank
Father, I'm here to
Jesus.
Do everything in a righteous way that you would want me to.
Thank you,
Lord,
Jesus.
Thank you, Father. Thank you for leading and guiding me,
Lord.
Thank you for clearing my way. Thank you for giving
Lord,
me a new heart. Thank you for giving me a new hand. Oh, Lord, I desire to do all things to you. I desire to do things to you.
I want
to
be
I need
used
to do
you, Lord.
Well, thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah,
Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Take me,
Lord.
You have been there all these years.
I give my life.
Yahshua.
Make it out of me.
I put myself in your hands. I put myself
make
in your hands.
You want to be.
I put myself in your hands.
Oh,
to lead and guide and protect.
I submit to you.
Fill me with your wisdom and your word. Thank you.
Lord. I submit to you.
I give it all to you.
Every trial, every tribulation,
through everything, Lord, you always had compassion. You always showed love. You always showed kindness. You never departed from that. You stuck by your word. You stuck by your love. Father, please make that in me. Bring that to me, Lord. Place that love in me. Place that love in my heart. Place that in my mind. My soul. Everything that you would have me to have. Father, I ask you to receive it from me. Everything that you want me to be. I ask you to give it to me. Everything that I need to accomplish what you want me to do. You have given me all that you have. You have given me all that you have. Your word says that I can overcome anything. Your word says that I am a child of God. Your word says that I am trusted. Your word says that you will never leave me. Your word says that you are my Lord and Savior. Yea, that I shall not move.
Take control of everything that I am. Take control.
Changed my entire life, Lord. That changed my whole life.
Fast and pray and
and the not of flesh, then more spiritual things might begin to be released in it. And I was really blessed last night, Al Cleaver. We were praying, we were talking about almost an impossible situation. It was somebody that had been in this ministry that was here for a while, but they had some real challenges. And then the other day I asked Brother Al about just her person, because I think she had been going from church to church, church to church. And but that was a real concern that I had, because I felt like we should have been able to have done more, but it's difficult to help people against their will. Amen. Sometimes they have their own agendas, and just to do so much. And sometimes we can plan, and somebody else after water, and sometimes circumstances have to bring them in. Amen. Brother Al, you want to just, because we were praying about that. I mean, we were talking about that, deal, and it just happened the day after.
Yeah,
just kind of share with
them, Rick. What we were talking about is, we were talking about a young lady that I know, and she's a real sweet lady. When I was in need of a job, and I used to work at the Greenwood Culture Center, and I went back down there. She was there, and she and I prayed, and I got rehired and everything like that. And she was searching for church at the time, and I told her about Northside. And she came here, and she, started coming to church here quite regularly and everything. And she just all of a sudden just left, just kind of quit, some things were happening in her life, like that and stuff. And she had even gotten to a place she didn't even speak to me. She was mad, angry. And we work in the same place, and I go in her office, and when I go in her office, she'll go out there and go. It was just like that, And I knew it was nothing but the devil. Yeah. And I said to myself, well, all I can do is pray, and she'll find her way back. And I'll even talk to Rod about it a little bit, because he worked down there for a while. And I kept praying, and I just knew that one day, she need to come back to the Lord. And me and Pastor were talking, I think it was Tuesday morning. Pastor had asked me about it, and I was telling Pastor a little bit. Went to work, and I noticed when I went to work, she had a little smile on her face, and she kind of spoke to me. I said, maybe she's going to kind of come around a little bit. And yesterday, I went to work yesterday, she came up to me, and she just broke down in tears. And then she wept, and I prayed with her, talked to her, and I just told her basically, you can't just keep going from church to church. You got to settle yourself down somewhere. And she said, yes. She said, well, I need to pass this number, and gave her a number. So, me and him were talking about you yesterday. She said, ooh, he must have knew God, must have told him that I'm going through some trials. And we just prayed, and she cried, and she wept. But at the same time, I believe that she's going to make that attempt to come back here. And we just got to show her love and, show what type of people we are. And I just thank God that I can plant a seed in somebody's life. Somebody planted a seed in mine. And as I look around this morning, I think about my brother here, Frank. Frank and I, we met one another a couple months ago. And it was funny how we met. Our eyes just kind of connected. And we were both at a place that we didn't need to be. And all of a sudden, we got to speaking and talking. And we saw that we had something in common. And I told him about Northside. And, lo and behold, here he is. And his wife's here. And, I just take a lot of things like that. The power of prayer can really do a lot of things. So we have to stay steadfast, we have to stay prayed up, and God can turn anything around for us. So just keep praying, fasting, I'm learning how to fast.
Yes, brother.
Me and Rod.
Praise God.
Rod bought me some,
what's some things you bought me the other day?
Crawfish. Big old bag of crawfish. Still in my refrigerator. So, you know.
When you cooking.
After the fast, I'm gonna cook mine and I'm gonna go buy any meals.
Praise God.
Wonderful. But God is good.
Wonderful. Yes. Yes, He is.
Glory.
Praise
Glory.
God.
Glory.
Glory.
I just want to encourage everybody. whatever we are going because of Christmas. Real opportunity for you to completely release everything into God's hands. You know, we don't know how to get through a whole lot of things and deal with a whole lot of things that we are contending with, but it's just a good time to just turn everything over to God.
Amen.
And you'd be surprised at how, when you release it and let go and let God, how God can work.
Yes.
Amen. Hallelujah. God is concerned about everything that we are going through. He's touched with the feelings of our infirmities, all of our hardships and struggles and all of that. We just need to just cast it all over to God. Amen. And cry out like a baby. Right? And cry out like a baby.
Yes, yes.
God will give you grace. The Bible says God resists the proud, but He gives grace to the humble. That's one way you know you can get strength to go through and to be released from everything that you, amen, you're under. Amen. God will always give grace to the humble. And when a person cries out and express their need for God and just hunger and thirst for God, amen, that will always be reflected in the sincerity that you will display. Brokenness and the weeping and the crying. Amen. After all, we can do nothing without Him. And all of our help comes from Him.
Amen.
Amen. So I'm crying out. Amen. Praise God. I'm crying out just like everybody else crying out.
Hallelujah.
A lot more. Amen. It's very difficult to, amen, to do, to work with so many people and trying to find answers and solutions and trying to be a light and be that source of strength. And amen. Praise God. So it's just something that all of us have needs. And we just want to, amen, take our burdens all to the Lord. And we just want to leave them at His feet. Amen. So we just praise God for each and every one of you. Amen. Today, if you haven't hooked up yet, amen, today would be a good day since it's kind of late in the week. Amen, you might just need to just make it all water today. Amen, all water, amen. If you haven't done nothing at all, it definitely needs to be all water. All water, amen. And it's water that Brother Holman got, Brother Judd got. Travis got one machine. That's what's going to give you strength, and you get a whole lot of the minerals that your body needs to sustain itself. So you're kind of ahead of the game with the right kind of water, because it doesn't deplete you and doesn't wear you down and be so weak and all that. So you'll be good. Want some of that water? Brother Chud is over there. Brother Travis.
Yes, God.
Calling him. Amen. My filter is dirty. And my machine, I'm not drinking from my machine until my filter comes. Amen. But we just want to encourage you in your effort to seek the Lord. And we just believe that when this whole church gets on fire, all of us completely surrendered,
amen,
we're going to see a revival. We're going to see a real, real move of God.
Yeah.
We're going to see miracles, signs, and wonders. Amen. So how long do y'all think it's going to take us to complete the survey?
All right, that's all I'll say. Amen. It's happening now. Any day. Amen. We can get that major breakthrough.
Hallelujah.
I felt something this morning. Amen. After last night, this morning, boy, I'm telling you.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen, Brother Rodney. He's very powerful. Amen.
Amen. You know what I'm talking about. Last night, man, I didn't.
Hey, now next week, not tomorrow, we will be praying.
Amen.
And I'm not going to be here next week. Let me see, I'll be here. I can be here Monday morning. Don't have to be up to town Tuesday. And I'll be here Thursday. I can pray next Friday, but I don't think that the prayer needs to stop because I'm out of town. So what day do y'all think y'all want to keep praying? Y'all want to do it Tuesday? Tuesday morning and Friday, Tuesday, Thursday. Y'all can do it however. Y'all let me know by tomorrow. Amen. Because we just want to keep this going for a while. Even if it's just two mornings a week, it still would be better than nothing. Now unto him that is able to keep us from falling and to present us faultless before his presence with exceeding great joy to the only wise God, be glory, honor, dominion, and